All right. And joining me now, Carl Dix, co-founder of both Rise of October and the Stop the Mass Incarceration Network. He was also an organizer at the protest last week in New York City. Now, last Saturday, good evening, I said last Saturday, I said I can't believe that they would have an anti-police protest within days of a police officer being shot. Was I wrong?
Well, look, we had that protest because police have been getting away with murder. They have been brutalizing and killing people, and the whole system, the legal system, the media has gone into operation to cover up their murderous deeds.
All right, let's talk about
the stop, and that's what we were acting to do.
All right, so you don't feel any remorse for having done this when police officer Holder had been shot and killed by a career criminal just days before that?
Okay, look, I'm not going to comment on what happened with Officer Holder. I'm going to comment.
Oh, well, you want to talk about police killing people, but you can't talk about criminals killing cops?
I'm not going to talk about that incident because I don't know what happened. There's very little information that's been put out. It's all come from the police. I don't know what happened. But I do know what happened to Eric Garner. We all saw him choke to death.
You know, Let's just find some common ground here. I know a lot of people who are very concerned about the Eric Garner case and the chokehold. But a grand jury with African Americans on it and
I don't care who was on it. Lie to me. I saw him choke to death.
You were there?
There's a video of it. You saw it too, I believe.
Chokehold, absolutely.
He was choked to death.
And the question is, you only see one angle of the video.
I don't need to see a whole bunch of angles.
No.
Because the prosecutor who went before the grand jury began the process by exonerating all of the cops except Daniel Pantaleo, who did the chokehold, even though they helped, including one who was kneeling in the back.
All right,
when you need their testimony, when you want to clear the perpetrators.
I know the drill.
He didn't need to give those other cops a pass.
In the last 10 months in New York, 4 cops have been shot. 2 sitting in the car, eating their lunch before Christmas. One guy ends up shot chasing a career criminal, and the 4th cop is shot again by someone with an intense criminal record. You don't see any reason to protest the killing of people that you need if you're in trouble?
Look, last year, about 30 cops nationwide have lost their lives in the line of duty. In the same time period, 1,000 people have been killed by police. 300 of them.
Yeah.
So far, from January 1st to today, the number is over 950.
I have 930. But
930 was a week ago. It was when we did our demonstration.
Let me ask you this, okay? If you're in trouble, who are you
300 of them.
Who are you going to call if you're in trouble?
Well, look, if you're in trouble and you call the police, often if you're black and Latino, then you got another problem.
No,
because
blacks.
We had 100 family members of people killed by police. Several dozen of them lost their loved ones' lives because they called 911 to get some help for a family member who was having a mental episode who ended up being killed by police.
You know what? Here's the bottom line.
This is part of the reality that we're dealing with.
Prosecuted bad cops. Gotta go.
Okay.
There is a system,
maybe,
and I'm telling you the system works.
The system works to exonerate killer cops. Almost gets punished, no matter how horrific.
Look into the case.
Look into those cases. Go to the Stop Mass Incarceration Network website. Look at it. That's the reality. Police are getting away with murder, and we are acting to stop it.
This case has me fired up.